गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द 10th लेक्चर ऑफ द फिनेंशियल प्लानिंग एंड कंट्रोल सिस्टम। फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव सीन लॉट ऑफ कंट्रोल मैकेनिज्म इन द लास्ट 9 लेक्चर्स। नाउ वी विल सी द नीड फॉर बजटिंग, देन वी विल सी द फोरकास्टिंग, बजटिंग प्रोसेस एंड कंट्रोल्स। फ्रेंड्स, वेदर इट इज़ अ स्मॉल और अ बिग ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, every company there is a need of the budgeting. We will also see some of the practical aspect of the budgeting. What happens is, if there is no budget in any organization planning, then the expenses, either a variable or a fixed expenses, will go haywire. So there is a need for the preparation of the budget, processing of the budget, and then every periodically there should be a checking of the budget, whether the organization functions are on the same line of what they have budgeted in the year beginning. So let us see the need for the budgeting. Budgets are essential in planning because they force management to think ahead and look before they leap. Unless we have the budget very proper, we will not be able to know where we are going. The main reason for the need of the budgets are, it reduces the uncertainties, so we are very sure that what we are doing and where we are going ahead. It increases the coordination amongst the different departments, so there is a sales team, production team, and accounts team, HR team. The coordination will be proper, and they will always see that the whatever the expenditure they have planned or they budgeted is are going regularly, and there is no variances. If there is a variances, maybe on a higher side, on a lower side, there should be a revision in the budget. Budget also identify the weaknesses by finding out the reason for the inefficient performance. It will always highlight the performance which is inefficient. So when a person is not able to spend any money, what is that they have budgeted in the year beginning, it also show the inefficiency. If they are overshooting the budget, it also show the inefficiency of the particular department. Budget helps managers to analyze the expenditure and it keep it under check. Thereby, it prevents the wastage of the all kinds. Budget helps in the establishment of performance standard for the operational activities. Unless you have the budget, then you cannot give a SOP of a particular production activity. Say for example, in a ballpen industry, if you do not have the target or the standard output, then you will never know whether the operator is releasing or the producing so many number of ballpen in a day, or so many number of ballpens in a year, or so many number of the ballpen in a particular shift. So because of the budget, the adoption of the standard costing is also possible. Budget helps to identify deviations from pre-planned course of the action. So whatever we have planned, it also see that the whatever we have planned and we are achieving the particular thing. It helps in evaluating the performance against the standard. As I said, the variances. Now, how to formulate the budget? There has to be a budget department, budget committee, issuance of the guidelines, how to prepare the budget, what kind of the formats we need to follow, initial budget proposal. There should be a negotiation between the management and the SBO. Say for example, there is a ballpen industry having the ballpen company, then tips, then refill, and then sketch pen. So this is the organization chart. Now if ballpen industries is negotiating for some expenses, the organization may say yes, the tip required to manufacture the ballpen or to suffice the ballpen manufacturing, then there has to be a negotiation between these two based on the manufacturing capacity. Similarly for the refills, Here it is an independent sketch pen, so there is no feedback needed from the ball pen company, ball pen division or the tape division or the refill division. And there has to be a reviews, and there has to be a revision. So the moment there is a reviews, there has to be a revision, and there is an administration of the budgets. Advantages: presentation of overall managerial view. It narrows down the gap between the planning and the performance. It promotes division of work and specialization. It's very simple, and the no need to explain further. It fosters the coordination and the integration between the departments. Systematic administration and successful implementation of the controls results in the sound budget for the enterprise. It will also have a close watch on the performance. The following steps should be considered to achieve the effective controls. One, first of all, we need to organize the budget, assigning the responsibility for the budgeting, determining the budget period, that is normally a year, determining the key success factor, and preparing the budget report. This budget report may be monthly, quarterly, yearly, right? Now, what is the master budget and what are the contents of the master budget? Friends, this master budget is the overall budget. It's a helicopter view. And these are the contents of the master budgets. Friends, whenever in an industry, I'm just telling you the practical approach. The first of all, there is a sales budget is to be prepared. The sales budget need a manufacturing budget. Manufacturing need a purchase budget. And purchase need a admin, IT, finance, HR, and then you have a selling and distribution budget. This is what it's given here. The sales budget, production budget, material means a purchase budget, admin, labor, promotion, research budget, R&D. Wherever there is the R&D, then you need to have a budget so that the liquidity point of view, it will help, and it will be helping for the cash flow preparation. Then capital expense budget, because we need to find out the depreciation and all, selling and distribution, and then a finance budget. Steps, as I said, the first will be have the sales budget, and then manufacturing budget, and there will be a income statement will be prepared after the master budget, and then finally whether the profitability shown in the budget or no, we will have a cash flow budget. Friends, please understand that for the growth of any organization, for sustainable growth of any organization, to sustain in an industry of any organization, the organization require three things. One, cash flow. Two, cash flow. And three, cash flow. So without cash flow budget, your budget is incomplete. There are two methods, direct method and indirect method, as per the accounting standard. Normally, people follow the direct method because it is very simple and understand. But if you are in accounts team or the finance team, you will have to follow the indirect method, because it gives you into three activities, that is operational activity, then financing activity, and then investment activity. Investment activity, we will have the capital budget. So if you are a core team of the finance act person or the division, then you follow the particularly the indirect method. Otherwise, you can follow the direct method. And finally, we will have a capital budget. And then, of course, the balance sheet to prepare the actual comparison with the previous years. There is a concept of zero-based budgeting. Zero-based budgeting is normally what happens is we follow the trend of the previous quarters or the previous years. In zero-based budgeting, we don't follow the previous quarters or previous year. We just follow the what is that we are going to do if we are starting at a zero level. So it starts with all the activities of preparing the purchase, getting quotations, administrative activities, all will start with a zero base. So we will not have any information, we will not drag with the previous information. We will only see what is that if I will start with a zero, what will be my expenses and what will be my sales revenue. As I discussed, it is not based on the previous years. It is to be taken as if we are doing for the first time. Zero-based budgeting is a decision-oriented. It relies on the manager's decision regarding the cost required for the carrying out a particular activity. So it is very specific. You cannot have any previous quarter or the previous year's impact on the zero-based budgeting. In traditional budget and the zero-based budget, if you want to see the difference is, it is traditional budget, sometime it's inflated by the managers, but zero-based budget, it is a rational analysis. In traditional budget, top management is usually involved in preparation of the budget, whereas in zero-based budget, responsibility center manager takes the necessary decision. So it is not that the top-down approach in the zero-based budget. In traditional based budget, there is a top-down approach. In zero-based budget, it is easy to identify the important projects that require management attention, whereas in traditional budget, it is very difficult. Analyzing financial performance report is based on the various analysis when we compare on a yearly, half yearly or a quarterly basis. And these are the major variances: revenue variances, that is the sales difference, sales price variances, say what price you have taken the order and what price you have dispatched and what price you have planned earlier, volume variances, volume means production quantity, mix variances, it's a product mix, say how much ball pen or how much sketch pen or how many refills you have sold, expenses variances, we have a different variances, and usage means a consumption. So if we have planned input of 10 against the output of 1, and if you are doing input of 12 against the output of 1, so there is a variance of 2. This is what I would like to specify here. Thank you, friends. As I always say, that grow yourself, the sky is the beginning, and there is no limit for any kind of learning. Be in touch. We will be coming with the another video in the next lecture of number 11. We will be clearing the balance scorecard. How the balance scorecard is there and how we are doing it, we will look at the next lecture. Thank you very much, friends.